I go on about reflux a lot in my videos, my blogs, and when I speak on the subject of veins at meetings. It might sound a little theoretical, but I'm going to show you the proof that reflux is important. With the exception of deep vein thrombosis, nearly all leg vein problems are due to reflux. Now, whenever any fluid travels in the wrong direction in the body, the term reflux is used. So, for example, if acid comes up in the wrong direction in the chest, the person is said to have acid indigestion. Acid should go downwards to digest the food. Well, blood flow in the veins should go up the legs, from the foot towards the heart. If the one-way valves inside the veins are not working properly, gravity can pull the blood down towards the foot, and the term vein reflux is used. This downflow of blood in the wrong direction is the common cause of varicose veins and thread veins, as well as complications such as varicose eczema and leg ulcers. Reflux is also a risk factor for DVT. Often, the reflux is in the veins a little distance from the surface. You can't see reflux in these veins by just looking at the leg. Professor Mark Whiteley has called these veins hidden varicose veins, simply because they can't be seen. However, the refluxing backflow can reveal itself as either lumpy side branches, visible varicose veins, or as thread veins. Even if the reflux remains hidden, it can still cause ache, pain, throbbing, varicose eczema, leg ulcers, and DVT. This lady had reflux in the saphenous vein, and the backflow came from the top of her thigh right down to her ankle. The saphenous vein and the reflux in it could only be detected by a duplex ultrasound scan, but the downflow also caused distension of surface side branches, giving rise to the varicose veins we can see. I treated her with Venoseal, a medical superglue. With only one local anaesthetic jab and using ultrasound to guide me, I was able to introduce a tiny catheter into the refluxing saphenous vein near her ankle and gently thread it up to the top of the refluxing vein in her thigh. Using minuscule amounts of medical superglue, I closed the vein and stopped the reflux. Now, when she gets out of bed and stands up first thing in the morning, blood no longer refluxes down her leg and the varicose veins no longer fill. They have returned to normal and have disappeared. I only treated the reflux. I didn't do any stripping and I didn't operate on the surface varicose veins. Yet, by treating the hidden varicose veins, the reflux in the saphenous vein, the surface visible veins have disappeared. That's the importance of vein reflux. Now, if you are interested in vein problems and you would like to keep up to date, please click the button above and subscribe. That way, you'll be among the first to see our next video. Why not leave a question in the box below? I'd love to hear from you, and I will do my best to get back to you as soon as possible. Thank you for watching.